once in a while, but not as much as I used to. I used to do more nonfiction than fiction. Then I just wasn't like being able to stick with it. My attention span wasn't that great. But I read Tarot for Change on audiobook, and I was trying to take it in, but I was like, this is like textbook stuff. Like, I need a physical copy and not a physical copy from a library. Something I can mark up and underline and notate and post it and just completely abuse. And so I was like, I really need to get this book, a real copy of this book, and just have it out on like my dining room table or in the kitchen and just, you know, just violate this book every day. And, you know, TJ Maxx usually doesn't have books like that, and it didn't. It only had like a few recipe books, and I was like flipping back through like the journals, and what do you know? Like, this is so crazy because I've only wanted, I don't ever buy physical books anymore. I either get them on my Libby app or the library. I will, actually, I don't even really read library books anymore, but I'll get them to my Kindle from the library. So the only book that I've wanted in a really long time was this book, and they had it. That was absolutely crazy. Like, my, I was like, what are the chances of the one book that I wanted being the one book that I found on this shopping trip? Throw it in the cart. Damn it. But Tarot for Change, using the cards for self-care, acceptance, and growth, which is what I usually, I mean, not usually, like, that's what I do with my cards. Like, I'm not a psychic. I have some abilities, and I've seen things, but I don't use the cards for, like, telling the future. I read them for, like, current, like, to dissect a current situation and just to, like, show me where I need to look at or, like, where should I be focusing or what should I be made aware of so that I can, you know, just examining my current energies. And I'll read you the little insert or synopsis. Tarot is often thought of as a tool for divination and fortune telling. It also has deep roots in spirituality and psychology. For those who know how to see and listen, the cards hold the potential to help us better navigate the full spectrum of the human experience. In Tarot for Change, Jessica Dorr divulges years of hard-won secrets about how to work with tarot to better understand ourselves and live in alignment with what's precious. Dorr shows readers how to choose a deck, interpret images, and build a relationship with the cards, while also demonstrating how the mythic imagery of tarot supports modern therapeutic concepts like mindfulness, acceptance, and compassion. Her reflections on each of the 78 cards are a vibrant tapestry that weave together ideas from psychology, behavioral science, spirituality, and old stories, breathing new language into ancient wisdoms about what it means to be human. As much a book for those who are new to tarot as for those who have worked with the cards for years, and it's a book for anyone interested in exploring what it means to experience joy, heartbreak, wonder, stagnation, grief, loneliness, and love. A book of secrets, symbols, and stories. Tarot for Change is a charm for remembering that our problems are not new, we are never alone, and whether we know it or not, we are always in a process of change. So, I can't wait to get into that book and do all my little nerdy, like, notation stuff in it. And then a little honorary mention, I got some new nails in. I'll probably put these on next unless it gets a little too close to Halloween, and then I'll want to wear like a black or a purple.